You may be on a rigorous weight loss diet, but it's almost impossible to avoid snacking. But who said snacking is always unhealthy? Hi, Health Nuts. I'm Anamika, and you're watching The Hungry Gypsy. If you're here for the first time, then this is my space where I share my love and passion for food, travel, and some other random shenanigans of mine. So if you're interested in that kind of stuff, hit that big red subscribe button right now, and there is a bell icon also, hit that as well, so that you get my latest video updates first. Now, who doesn't like snacking? I know I do. So today I have got 4 delicious, easy, and super healthy snack ideas for you guys. You can batch make all these snacks and store them for up to 1 to 2 weeks and enjoy a healthy snack whenever you want. So let's start, shall we? Starting with my favorite one of the lot, fruit and nut froyo cups. These are so easy to make and they are super yummy with goodness of fruits, nuts and yogurt. These frozen yogurt treats are sweet, tart, tangy, beautiful and delicious. Let's make them. These are the ingredients that we are going to need to make our froyo cups. So here I have about a cup of Greek yogurt. You can use any yogurt of your choice. You can use flavored yogurt or plain yogurt. You can even use hunkered. Just make sure that it's thick and not liquidy. Next thing that we'll need is a tablespoon of honey. You can use any other sweetener of your choice. If you're using flavored or sweetened yogurt, you need not add any additional sweetener. So I'm just going to add this honey to my yogurt and mix it well. Next, I have here some chopped nuts. Now, I have taken some walnuts, some almonds, and some cashew. You can use any nuts of your choice. These nuts will form the base or crust of our frozen yogurt. Now, to set my frozen yogurts, I'm going to use these silicone molds. I find them very convenient and easy to unmold once the yogurt is frozen. These are very inexpensive and you can easily find them in the baking section of your nearest supermarket, or you can even purchase them online. I'll leave the links from where you can buy these things online in the description box below. If you don't want to use these silicone molds, you can simply use your muffin tin lined with some cupcake or muffin tin liners. So I'm going to start with adding the nuts to my silicone mold and I'm just going to press them a little bit to kind of make a nice base. You can add as much as you'd like. I like a thin nutty base, that's why I'm not adding too much here. About this much is good enough for me. Now it's time to add the yogurt into the cup. I'm going to fill about 2/3 of the cup with this yogurt honey mix. And finally, I'm just going to top it up with my favorite fruits. I have some nice seedless grapes here and some beautiful strawberries. You can use any fruits of your choice. Blueberries, blackberries, raspberries, kiwis go really well in this recipe. And that's it. Assemble the rest of your froyo cups in the same way and let it sit in the freezer for 4 to 5 hours or until it gets frozen. Once out of the freezer, your fruit and nut froyo cups are ready to come out of their molds and see how easily it unmolds from these silicone cups. And doesn't this look beautiful? Look at all the beautiful layers of nuts and then the yogurt and fruits on the top. Perfect fix for a hot midday snack, or you can even have this as a dessert. Guilt-free snack number one is served. Moving on to healthy snack idea number two. Now, I make a healthy food video and I don't feature any oats recipe in that. That almost never happens. So here's my incredibly healthy and super delicious oats banana protein cookies for you guys. Let's start. You'll need 2 very ripe bananas. Peel the bananas, break them into pieces and add them to a big bowl. The riper the banana, the more flavorful and sweeter it will be. Now take a fork and start mashing the banana. Keep mashing it until you get a liquidy consistency. Once your mashed banana starts to look like this, go ahead and add 1 cup of quick cooking oats to this. You can use old fashioned rolled oats here, but I feel that instant quick cooking oats work best in this recipe. Give it a good mix. And now your base is ready. Now we'll go ahead and add the rest of the ingredients to it. First thing that I'm going to add is 1/4 scoop of vanilla protein powder for the extra boost of protein. Next goes in a tablespoon of unsweetened cocoa powder for a rich chocolatey flavor. Next goes in a teaspoon of honey for a little extra sweetness. And finally a tablespoon of peanut butter. You can use any nut butter of your choice, or you can skip this as well if you're not really a fan of nutty flavor. Now give this all a good mix. Keep mixing until everything comes together, and this is how your cookie batter should look like. Now take a baking tray and line it with a baking sheet or a parchment paper so that nothing sticks. And now let's start transferring the cookie batter onto the tray. So I'm using a tablespoon of cookie batter per cookie here. You can use a small ice cream scoop or simply a spoon to do this step. This recipe will make about 11 to 12 cookies. And then I'm just gonna go ahead and press all the cookies with the back of my tablespoon to kind of spread them and give it a more cookie-like shape. Finally, these babies are ready to go into a preheated oven. Bake them for 12 to 15 minutes at about 180 degrees Celsius or as per your oven's heat settings. Once out of the oven, let the cookies cool down completely, and that's it. Now you have your soft and chewy, delicious, nutrient-rich, healthy oats banana protein cookies that you can munch on any time of the day and not feel guilty about it. How awesome is that? Moving on to the last easy and healthy snack idea in this video, next up is my roasted masala chickpeas, or simply known as masala chana. So my dear munchies, let's make this. First thing that you're gonna need is obviously chickpeas. So I have here one can or about 440 grams of cooked chickpeas or garbanzo beans. Now if you're not using canned chickpeas, then go ahead and soak your chickpeas overnight and then cook them before you can use them in this recipe. Here I have already washed and drained my chickpeas. Make sure that you allow the water to completely drain out and then pat it dry with a cotton cloth or a paper towel. You don't want any moisture in there, so make sure to dry it out as much as possible. Once the chickpeas are nice and dry, go ahead and season it. So I'm going to make masala chickpeas today, hence I'm using all Indian spices here for that tangy, spicy masala flavor. So here I have some chili powder, some cumin powder, some garam masala, and some pink Himalayan salt. Let's just add that to the bowl, just sprinkle it all over. And lastly, I'm just going to add about a tablespoon of extra virgin olive oil to this. And now just toss it all up really nicely. Just make sure that all the chickpeas gets coated in this oil and seasoning mix. This is looking nice. Now let's get the baking tray. So again, I'm going to line it with a parchment paper or a baking sheet and then pour all the content onto the baking tray and then just spread it out evenly. Now this is going to go into a preheated oven and I'm going to roast it for about 25 to 30 minutes at 180 degrees Celsius. I'm going to take the tray out every 10 minutes and just toss and turn and kind of redistribute the seasoning before putting it back into the oven again. And just keep an eye on it while it's roasting because it tends to get burned really quickly. Once done, let it cool down completely and then transfer it to an airtight container. This will keep good for up to 2 weeks in an airtight container at room temperature. That's it, munchies. Your healthy, delicious munching is ready. Sprinkle some chaat masala on top of it if you like, or you can use some dried herbs or garlic powder, onion powder, anything. You can season it as you like. Possibilities are endless. So which one was your favorite snack and which one are you going to try making next? Let me know in the comment section below. Don't forget to leave a big fat thumbs up for this video and please subscribe. You can follow me on Instagram, Twitter and Facebook to know more about me and my upcoming videos, you know, what I do when I'm not making videos. I would love to get connected with you guys on my other social media platforms. I'll see you in my next one. Till then, you stay healthy, stay happy. Okay, bye.